Hello, my name is Amy Sturkey. I am a pediatric physical therapist with a little over 30 years of clinical practice. And I thought I'd just do a video on what I think of the basics of imitation. And the first thing I think about is the kid has to be watching for them to be able to imitate you. This is a huge problem for my kids on the autistic spectrum because they don't want to look at people. They have poor eye contact. So some of the things I think about in terms of helping them being able to imitate is I think of a demonstration that happens close by someone to be much more meaningful than a demonstration done far away. So close by is better. I think about a demonstration done across a football field for me is not as meaningful as one up close to my face. Same thing for them. If I'm across the room from them, I might as well be across the football field. The next thing I think about is I want to be eye level with them. So if they're sitting, I get down on a knee to be able to do the demonstration if that's appropriate. I also try not to be off to their side. I tend to try to be right on square in front of them to make it a little bit easier for them to watch. Another thing for you to think about is who is doing the modeling of the demonstration. They're just like when somebody yawns, you're more likely to also yawn if it's somebody you love or somebody you are close to. You're more likely to yawn if they yawn. So the same way, someone who is modeling, if they're someone the child loves, more like a family member, they're more likely to imitate it than somebody that they barely know. I do a lot of video modeling. So if I'm trying to teach them to cross their arms on the chest or put their arms out to the side, I will have a family member, maybe a brother or a mother or a father, somebody do that video for the child to look at, because sometimes it's easier for our kids on the autistic spectrum to watch a video than it is to watch a person. A video can be less threatening because it happens the exact same way over and over. So a lot of times kids on the autistic spectrum will watch a video model better than a person modeling live in front of them. One of the things I see with children on the autistic spectrum is they do not look at a demonstration even when I'm smack in front of them. And so that can be really tricky. So what I will do is I will ask a parent who's sitting right beside them to help them look, meaning I will help have them turn their head and have them look at the relevant detail of the demonstration. For example, if I'm walking on my tiptoes and they're looking up at my face, I'll have the parent help them look down and point down to make them know that that's important. If they're walking on a line and I'm trying to get them to walk on the line and imitate, I'll make sure that they're looking down at the feet on the line as opposed to looking out. Because again, if they don't see it, they're not going to know what it is that they're supposed to imitate. The next thing I think about in terms of imitation is I see a lot of times that my clients on the autistic spectrum learn best if you physically take them through the movement first. And then after they've been physically taken through it, it's almost like they don't learn by watching, but they learn by feeling it. Now, the research says that in typically neurowired people, that there's something called mirror neurons. And with mirror neurons, we're wired so that if I see someone crying, then I want to cry too. And if somebody's really happy, that it makes me happy too. We know that, and socially we see that, but it's also true just in terms of everything that somebody else does. If somebody in front of me is drinking a glass of water, that there's part of my brain that's also mirroring that action. They're called mirror neurons, and they are also simultaneously drinking that glass of water in my mind. So mirror neurons are really important for learning to copy. So it's really important that when you work on imitation, that you go through the process first of, if I want you to copy something, that I verbally ask you to do, I'm doing it, I ask you to verbally do it too. I want you to raise your arms. I want you to raise your arms. If they can't do that, then the next step I'll do is I'll give a prior model. I want you to do like this. I want you to raise your arms like this. Can you do that? And then let them do it. If they can't do it with a verbal cue, they can't do it with a prior model, the next thing I'll try is with an immediate model. I'll check like this. Can you raise your arms? Let's do it. Come on, you do it. Raise your arms. Come on, raise your arms. Let's do it together. If they can't do it that way, then the next step I'll do is a prior model. I'll help them. Let's raise your arms. Oh, you need help? Let me help you. It feels like this. Raise your arms. Raise your arms. Okay, let's do it together. Raise your arms. So if they can do it with me physically helping them first and then they do it, then that's called a prior model. I see if they can do it with me helping them first and then they do it on their own. And then the last way I consider that on the scale of imitation is if even with me doing it for them first, they can't do it, that they need physical assistance, either minimum, moderate, or a full assistance for them to be able to raise their arms or whatever it is they're trying to copy. And sometimes that's a little tap cue or a little touch to get the movement going. So I'll quantify how much support they need. But that's kind of the progression I go through. And I think a lot of times families will go immediately to the full physical assistance and then have them do it when they need to start earlier in the process. When I'm unsure where a child can do, I always start with the least amount of support first, and then go up through the spectrum of assistance to see what kind of help they need. I hope this is helpful in terms of thinking about imitation and how I think about teaching imitation skills to my clients. This is just a broad overview of what I think are the basics. Look forward to seeing you next time and have a great week. Bye-bye.
If you liked this video and would like to be notified by email when the next video comes out, click the subscribe button here and click the golden bell icon and ensure notifications are enabled on your account.